In this video, you will learn how to diagnose a 1668 through 1671.02 DTC. Before starting any procedure, it is important to recognize safety information, understand safety signals, wear recommended personal protective equipment, and be familiar with your operator's manual. During machine operation, a sink line fault may become active. This fault indicates the nozzle reporting the fault is no longer receiving a frequency signal on the sink input line from the adjacent nozzle body inboard. If this fault is the only active fault, the machine will allow the operator to continue spraying. Note that if the operator performs a key cycle of the machine, this active fault may result in a 16.11 active trouble code, resulting in additional faulted nozzles. The nozzles will no longer be able to spray after this fault. Navigate to the nozzle turret status page by tapping on the boom and scroll to identify the nozzle reporting the fault. This example shows nozzle 56 reported the sink line fault. We will need to focus our diagnostic efforts on this nozzle, the next nozzle inboard, and the harnessing in between. While most of the next steps could be performed using only a multimeter, it is recommended to utilize the JDG11925 test box for the following tests. Note the sink line is in an active series circuit coming into the nozzle body on pin 5 and going out on pin 1 to the next nozzle adjacent outboard. Set the test box switches to on and connect lines to unit. Set your multimeter to Hertz readings. Disconnect the nozzle body from the harness and connect the JDG11925 test box to the boom harness. Leave the nozzle connection unplugged. Plug the red lead into the sink in port of the test box. Do not plug in the black lead as there can be feedback on the ground to give a false positive reading during diagnostics. If the multimeter is reading 0 Hz, we either have a broken circuit or a failed output from the nozzle body inboard of the nozzle reporting the fault. In this example, we have 0 Hz on the sink in from the nozzle reporting the fault. We need to move the boom harness connection to the next nozzle inboard and test for sink out. Connect the test box to the boom harness and nozzle body inboard from the nozzle reporting the fault. Move the red lead to the sink out port. We should be receiving 15 Hz on the sink out from the nozzle body. If we have 15 Hz, we have a failed circuit from pin 1 of the nozzle body inboard to pin 5 on the nozzle connector reporting the fault. Repair the circuit. If we have 15 Hz on the sink in, we may have a failed input internal to the nozzle reporting the fault, or a poor connection from the connector terminal to the nozzle body. Reconnect nozzle, key off machine, and back on to see if the fault persists. If the fault remains, we can verify if a new nozzle will resolve the issue with two methods. The first method is to use the diagnostic test box. The second is to use a spare nozzle body. For the first method, set the diagnostic test box to power off bypass loopback. Cycle power. If the fault moves to the end of the subnet, replace the nozzle body. If the fault remains, repair the harnessing. The other method is to plug in a spare nozzle body, cycle machine key power, off and back on. Wait 2 minutes. If no faults remain active, replace the nozzle that is disconnected. This video has shown how to identify and diagnose what to repair for an MNA 16.02 diagnostic trouble code. Thanks for watching.